This park in Antwerp was a hotspot for Islamist recruiters luring young Belgians to battlefields in Syria and Iraq. Now some of them are headed back, making many communities nervous. Earlier returnees trying to reintegrate in society are reluctant to be identified. Antwerp City Councillor Hisham Elmzer knows some of them personally and asked them to share their stories with me. Nobody was willing to speak.
Many of them came back with a huge feeling of shame. And they don't want to show that or to show their name or to be on TV to say, okay, I went there and I was a fool and I came back.
There are some exceptions. Laura Pisoni was all over TV in 2016, publicizing her book about being an Islamic State militant's bride in Syria. She decided to escape when her four-year-old son was taught to behead a teddy bear, as shown in this jihadi propaganda. Now Pisoni occasionally visits schools as part of the Belgian government's anti-radicalization efforts, but she declined our multiple requests for an interview. Some returnees have other motives for staying in the shadows. Those are the ones that worry Hisham Elmzer and Antwerp's Muslim community.
They don't want us to see that they are back. And they, to be honest, they don't show any feeling of shame. They are more frustrated about the fact that IS and their caliphate is losing. But they are here.
That's how returnee Mikael Delafortri seems to feel. Set free after receiving a suspended sentence, Delafortri also wrote a book and publicly praised Islamic State. He said his only regret was coming back. We couldn't speak with him as he's in prison on unrelated charges.
Sources tell me returnees and their families are urged to keep a low profile by Belgian authorities, but they're not the only ones. I'm told the brother of a Belgian fighter gave a television interview a couple of years ago with his identity disguised, but Islamic State supporters found him and beat him up very badly. A warning to others to keep quiet.
Local communities are figuring out how to deal with people who return. Vilvoorde, just north of Brussels. Many youths left this suburb to join IS. Mayor Hans Bonte has taken a personal interest in them. He visits them in prison to make sure they understand their choices. He warns them that after their release, they will be under constant scrutiny. But that's not all, he tells them.
The second thing I said is, when you are free, you are a free man. You have had your punishment. You have the right, and we will help you in all the opportunities, to give you all the opportunities to reintegrate in a positive way.
Bonte gives us an example of how his city supported one returnee committed to being a law-abiding citizen by being completely transparent about the situation.
And we informed the employer who was ready to give him a chance after all the information that we have got was transferred to that employer. The same thing on the housing side.
That man is still a success story 2 years later, but there are more IS followers being groomed. Peter van Oostingen, one of the best-known researchers of the Belgian jihad movement, says he sees no decrease in pro-jihad language on social media.
How strong is their influence? Well, basically, we'll only know when the next attack happens, I'm afraid.
However, the Belgian government appears a bit more optimistic than van Oostingen. It has reduced the national terror threat level, meaning an attack is no longer considered probable, but rather unlikely.